now it's time to be creative. So here you see me starting off with our moon mold from our Sophie and Toffee box. Here I'm putting in a thin layer of resin, and just to kind of start off our design, think of it like the glass to a frame. We want to really stand out the decorations we do. And then cure it. This I'm using the mini lamp that came with our kit. All the decorations, so I decided to use resin just to kind of hold everything in the layers. Next, I decided to get the little film sheet, and I picked my favorite seaweed design, and I put it in the conclusion. To fit this, I found it best to cut it as close to the edge of the design as possible. And then afterwards, I added a few decorations and blew little caviar bubbles into the designs to give that real underwater look. Now it's time to add the background. Don't forget to pop a hole into your resin dye. This I've done many times and forgetting and wondering why it wouldn't come out. I love the mixing part. I think it looks so cool. So the little tray you see me using is a bead tray. This is commonly used for sea beads, and you'll find this in any craft stores. I love this, and I found they were very easy to clean up when using resin. Next, I got the eye that came in our kit, and I am going to use it to add in a loop for the dangle we'll be adding on later. Now, this purple dye did not come with the kit. And yes, that's my parrot who flew over and decided to attack my tweezers once again. So naturally, when doing this, the resin filled perfectly in the concave of the shape, because when resin heats, it shrinks. So it kind of leaves like a little scoop in it. So this is very easy to fill on the back outside of the mold. Now, unfortunately, I didn't do the resin quick enough because of my parrot, so a mistake happened and the pen was covered. So what I did is I took a Dremel and I ended up going in and fixing it. This is perfectly okay to branch your creativity and find creative resolutions to solve problems like this. Of course, mine was an easy fix, but not all the time are they. So please, do not get discouraged whenever you create. And here you see me adding just a little bit of resin to kind of give that nice window effect. This really made like that dome look and gloss up the design on the inside. Plus, it let me add in decorations. And once again, there's my baby attacking my hand. Isn't this beautiful? I love how it's turning out so far. Here I'm showing you the layers I was talking about. Next, we're gonna move on making a mold for the hair stick. I picked a hair stick that I already had, and I got one of the stick packs of mold that we got. Now, unfortunately, the cup of water was not hot enough and would not stay hot enough longer to heat up the mold. So what I had to do is stand in front of the microwave and microwave the water every time, and then put the mold in, shape it, and then pull it out once again. Then once your mold is ready and you're happy with it, you can move on to creating. Here I started my first layer following the same concept for my moon and to doing the same thing for my hair stick. For this, I'm doing half and half, and I want to combine the two halves into one stick. This, if you'll see, as the video goes on how that works. Next, I used the cute confetti that they gave us in our box, and I decided to fill in with decorations down the stick, just to kind of see what it would look like when it was done. This little trick I actually found to be really cool and beautiful. I love the way the light reflects. Ah, it looks like a fairy wand. Now I'm adding into the background of the stick. I wanted to see if this would pop the confetti's iridescence even more. Later on, I will tell you, I thought it was cooler when it was clear like an icicle. Again, don't forget to make two of these. Now that we have both sides of our sticks, we're going to smooth the rough edges down with a four-sided nail buffer. Of course, right now you don't have to polish, so just feel free to use the rough edge and just smooth it down. Now that it's smoothed down, we're going to add resin to the center and attach the two pieces. This you want to take your time with. Trying to do the whole stick would get messy and it would not stay together. So take it one step at a time. Now we can polish the stick. And as you can see, you don't need a super good buffer to do it either. After that, you want to take the resin again and add in a clear coat, almost like using nail polish. Which if you don't have any resin, like me, I later ran out, I did use nail polish at the end. But that's for my second stick. Here we're going to now attach the moon to the stick. I used the molds that came in the kit to kind of brace the stick and to add the charm on. We are almost done. Don't forget to reinforce it once it's secured on there. This is very important if you have thick hair. Now taking one of the chains out of the little gemstone kits that we got in our box, I took a charm, added a little dot of resin on the back, cured it real quick before it fell off, and then added more charms on the chain and did the same thing to the other side. And of course, all of this again was found into our little buckets, little cups, whatever you want to call it, that we got from Sophie and Toffee, full of the little beads and charms and chain. Personally, I have to say I love hair sticks. I'm always putting my hair up in one for when I craft and create. So you have to tell me, do you like hair sticks? Now we have our chain for our dangles. From our Sophie and Toffee box, just grab a loop, put your chain on. It was a little small, so I couldn't put the little jump ring through the chain, so I just had to put it in where it moved. And then attach it onto your loop on the moon. Now, if the moving chain bothers you, you can always add resin on it in the position you like the stone, so it doesn't move back and forth. What do you think? Do you like this one? Or do you like the other one that we're about to see? This here, I'm gonna show you why I love using these trays. See how easy of a cleanup that was? Now we're moving on to our free giveaway, which is the Seashell Charm Shaker. So here I'm making this design. I really decided, you know what? I have been getting a lot of positive comments and loves from everybody and decided to show that love right back to my subscribers. So please, if you leave a positive comment and keep encouraging me, by my next video, I'm gonna do a random number draw and whatever number I pick for that subscriber, I'm gonna take and I'm gonna ask for your information and send you this hair stick. So if you're interested, definitely leave a positive comment to enter in this contest. Moving on with the designs, you can see I went ahead and started doing a thin layer of resin and making a dome into the little mold we got. This I would do multiple layers in. I did it for both the purple and the clear. You'll see I did two techniques on putting thin layers in. Either one is okay. But definitely do the two layers. This would help strengthen your shaker and just make it more durable. Gosh, this purple iridescence they sent is so beautiful. And I love purple. So as you can see, here's my third layer. And here I'm making it thicker, just like I did for the clear front part. Now I pulled mine out to show you what it looks like, but technically for you guys, just leave it in, you'll be just fine. Now we're gonna add in our little shaker pieces on the inside of whatever little charms you like to float around. For me, I decided to put in all my treasures because I was going for a magical girl wand kind of look. This little purple shell you see, I made my own mold using the little bead trays that I have, and I made molds of the little gold charms they sent, and decided to use some of those into the shell shaker because I thought they were super cute. Once you do that, just add some resin around the edge, stick the other one on, cure it, and then clean your edges up. Now you will have to check for holes. The biggest hole, of course, you're gonna want to be the one that you insert your water in. For the rest of it, just go ahead and do a backup seal of the edges, just to really secure and make sure everything's in. You definitely don't want leaks. Gonna do a test to see if I have a leak. This is a craft syringe. You can find these online. I get my stuff on eBay most of the time. Now, and Sophie and Toffee. So here it is okay. I showed I made a mistake and I had a leak. And I was going through with the process to show you how to fix it. Just clean the water up, identify where the leak is, and then resin it up. And now you can go back to filling your charm up. And of course the fluid I'm using is water. I don't use shaker fluid because I felt the water just helps everything move around a little better. Well, at least for smaller items. So now that the shaker works, we can move on to attaching it to the stick. Now I'm really getting excited because I love to decorate. Here I'm going to use the leftover purple iridescence that I have, and I'm going to reinforce the base of the shell charm, just so we don't lose it when we're twisting it up in your hair.
Oops!
I almost cured my resin in the tray. Now that it's perfectly sealed to the base, as you can see, I'm going to move on to decorating with rhinestones, because this is a princess ear stick. So I just used a little resin just to kind of hold it in place, and now I can fully wrap around the charm and do what I gotta do to decorate it and secure it in. Cut your little end piece off. I had three and decided to, instead of wasting them, cut them up and I'll use them decorating later. Now, I went in between each stones and I decided why not cover up the little connectors in between. This I also felt helped hold the rhinestones better. I put the drip of resin on top, so as I was working on the rest of it, it would drip down and cover it. Didn't it turn out good? So I felt like I wanted to add some fun to the front. This, I had the great idea to get the film we got from our box. So once again, I cut out a seahorse and a seaweed, and I used it to decorate on the front of the shell. Sorry guys, I kind of got out of frame a little. Now for this coral piece. Isn't it cute how it stacks on top? Now with the resin, like the moon charm, I'm just putting a little on top and throwing some beads and charm on, just to really pull in that princess look. So those little gold beads you see, for anybody who doesn't know, those are called caviar beads. So if you want to get some of those for other projects, feel free, or this one, Remeber. They are a lot of fun to use. Now to finish off, I actually ended up running out of resin, so what I did is I used my quick dry clear nail polish to give a shiny coat and finish it off. What do you think? Which one do you like better, the moon or the shell princess one? And if you really like this one, don't forget to leave a positive comment below, and you could be one of the people picked to get this as your free gift for watching. All right, time to take a look at the final product. So left and right, I made with the Sophie and Toffee box, and even the third one that you see in the video here, but the other ones, I got creative with and used other supplies from other boxes and things I had around the house. Which one's your favorite? Personally, the Sakura Card Captor one right here is mine. I love that anime. So cute! And let's not forget the unicorn one. Here I followed with the transparent look to kind of give that icicle effect. And then a cute little kawaii one. And for any of my viewers, if you didn't know, the yarn and the shells in the video are actually a sneak peek to the one I'm making now. So say, like, subscribe to me or stay tuned and just keep in touch, and that way you'll see what my next secret video is using some of the Sophie and Toffee supply box. And don't forget the giveaway surprise. All you gotta do is leave a positive comment, and if I draw your number of the order you comment, you get this gift. So thank you so much everybody for watching, and I send big hugs and just thank you. I am so happy that I have been reaching out to everybody and I've been able to be a positive encouragement into the world of creativity.